Roland Brazil is alive with Steve Angello right now. We're finally here. We've spoken long and since tomorrow night winter about this.
Right.
Tell me, how's it feel?
Cold.
Yes.
But the vibe's great. You know, the energy is good. I like this. You know, it's like in the middle of the jungle. It feels like it's exciting.
It's different here, and I'm learning that.
Yeah.
You've been here before.
I have.
You're in the middle of a Latin America tour as well,
right,
going on.
Yeah.
There's a lot going on for you right now.
Yeah.
There's lots of fireworks. Talk to me about what's about to happen here in Brazil. Not what's... You've been building up, building up, building up. You've been releasing music for weeks and weeks and weeks.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, you know, like, I always take every show really seriously, you know, like, regardless of what show it is. And I always want to, like, introduce something. I always want to do something. It's like new edits and new versions of things. There's no difference now, you know. I'm going to try out some unreleased stuff, as always, and just showcase what's coming. And I'm just excited. I'm going to have some fun with some old classics just to remind the crowd that I haven't seen for years, you know, just to like play around a little bit.
So we spoke in the summer.
No.
And you maybe didn't know that I asked Tiesto, I said, look, you know, you and the Swedes should do something. You really should. And he didn't say anything.
Yeah.
Did you know at that time?
No, I didn't actually. You know, I'll tell you why. Because we met at a festival this summer and we said, you know, we had a chit chat, you know, and just talking, and we were like, it would be so cool to see Tiesto as you performed and produced 15 years ago. And he was like, you know what, that's not a bad idea. And then we didn't talk anything. And then he was like, the following 3 days later, he was like, can I get the stems to Ray of Solar? And we were like, fair play, you know? We're like, yeah, of course. And then a week after that, he was like, here's the remix. And we're like, dope. You know, and we go back, you know, we've known each other for 20 plus years and been around each other for, you know, been very close friends and hanging out, and you know, we have true friendship, you know, so it's great to have him on anything that we've done, and we're just blessed to have great people around us.
So I'm gonna come back to Ray of Solar, yeah. But let me just say that this has to be the start of something else for you and Tiesto, because surely there has to be a half and half collaboration, maybe.
Maybe.
All right, we'll talk about that next year.
Yeah. Let's catch up.
Ray of Solar, you were so excited about talking about that with Seb back at the festival in the summer.
Yeah.
And now it's obviously got its own remixes like M-Pieces, Mal P.
Yeah,
talk to me about that as an animal.
It's such a special song in its raw form, because it's very like out of the norm for us to make something that doesn't have the intention of being a radio song, or it's a vibe, right? It's just a vibe. And it took off on its own life, and then and it kind of ran. And then, you know, we, Anfisa, been a huge fan of her for years. I love her energy when she performs. I love seeing her play. And it's like, she just has this like great energy, you know? Yeah, I love it. And Mal P, obviously, you know, newcomer to the big scene, and he's done amazing work, you know, and we heard really nice stories from him, saying how he grew up watching us when he was 14 and stuff. And that, like, every song that we've ever made or remix or whatever it is, it's always something personal involved, you know? It's like if we love someone or we look up to someone or there's something, you know? So I'm really pleased with all of that. And then the Tiesto remix, which it's its own beast, you know? And it's just great to touch different genres, but they've made remixes that really stand on their own, you know? And it's a beautiful vocal.
I want to ask you so much, but I know you're not going to give me answers. So you said in the summer, this was the end of a chapter.
Yeah.
And that there was something else coming.
Yeah.
What's the time frame now? Because now you've given us Ray of Solar.
We have so much music. And that's the thing. It's like, we've put so much time in the studio the past couple of years. So it's like endless amounts of music, you know, solo, duo, collapse, Swedish House Mafia stuff. Like we're almost overwhelmed with music, you know? So I'm for my solo stuff, I've been holding back. I could put out a record every week for 2 years, And everybody's like, no, you gotta chill, you know? You gotta chill. I'm like, why?
Steven Jelly is not chill.
No, because so we just like feed, I like to just feed the people music. Like, yeah. I don't necessarily like try to make something out of it. I'm just like, here's music, you know? And I'm excited. Yeah, but I'm, but I'm just excited to like, just, it takes a lot to get to a point when you're like, your guard is down. And you just want to have fun putting up music because everything has to be so serious nowadays. You know, every song is on a pedestal, every, like all the labels, like everybody's like, okay, it's this process, song, you know? Process. And I hate that process, you know? And it stands against everything I stand for.
You're a rebel.
No, but not only that, I grew up putting out records, you know? Like, I remember like just a couple years ago, I made probably 250, 300 releases, you know? Because I just like making music. And put it out, you know. So it's,
where's that USB stick? Come on, where is it? Yeah. I'm gonna get it. Yeah. It's an exciting time. Talk to me about this time next year. What's going to have happened then?
Yeah, we have the South America run now. We have some great Swedish House Mafia shows, obviously. We have a couple of really cool shows lined up. I can't say too much because we haven't announced it. But there's really special, like events that we are really proud of putting on. For the solo stuff, just keep on pushing. The size 20 vinyl is probably gonna be finished by Christmas. We have a beautiful box that I've geeked out way over budget, but it's like, it has to be.
It's a concept.
Yeah, it's a concept. And then just keep on pushing up music and like nurturing this young talent, you know, that's like coming through the label and just promoting their music on the big stage and like just having fun. Like, you know, there's no rule book, there's no like formula. I'm just gonna do whatever I feel like, whenever I feel like it, and just have fun.
What about a fixed home? Like, you've been traveling a lot.
Yeah.
So is it time for another residency? Maybe?
I don't know.
That's a yes, everybody.
No, but it could be, you know, like it would be, I want to keep on like just playing a lot. And I want to do all types of venues and stuff. I want to do like warehouses, clubs, big clubs, festivals, whatever, you know? Okay. And I'm going to have some fun with that, you know, going into a city, doing three different types of venues and like just playing with the thought of like, I showed up yesterday at some house party and I started playing. I was at another party later on at night and I started playing. And like, if I have my USB, I'm just going to play.
Love that. You still got that love and energy for the game.
Yeah.
So there's no residency in the week next year then?
You never know.
Not going back to pressure. Okay,
no. I mean, that would be the Solomon show I had there was insane.
Yeah.
I'll tell you that. Like, just going back to back with Solomon for me was, I love him, you know, and also as a music pioneer, but also as a person. He's such a great person. And we talked about it last year. We were like, we should do something together. And he's like, come through to Pasha. I'm like, let's do that, you know? And we had the show this summer. It was insane.
Okay.
It was crazy. Back to back with him.
It's on plus one, right?
Yeah, and we did 7 hours.
7 hours?
Yeah, we had a blast. We had a blast. Like, musically, like, it's so much freedom, you know? And I texted him after, when I woke up, he was like, that was a crazy, but we went over time, right?
Yeah.
The club wanted to shut down. I'm like, no.
One more.
Yeah, I'm like, no, danced him out of the booth. I'm like, let us play, you know? And then I texted him the next day. I'm like, thank you for giving me freedom, because that's what it is. It's a place where you can do whatever you like. Yeah. And that's rare. That's really rare. So more of that.
I've got to let you go, but what haven't we spoken about?
What happened?
What haven't we spoken about?
I don't know. More music, great shows. Tomorrowland Brazil is going to be nuts. It's a little windy, but I think we got the fire to help. I'm excited.
There's a lot of people excited. Yeah. Steve Angelo. It's always a pleasure.
Always.
You can spend a lot of time talking to this guy. Full of energy, full of enthusiasm.
Next summer we do a year, like a year recap for an in-an-hour special.
A one-hour special, you got it here, saying 1 hour special, we're putting it on record.
Steve, enjoy the main stage. It's ready for you, man. Thank you.